What is going on, everybody? It's Stas here. Welcome back to another video. So in this video, we're going to be doing an overall market update, taking a look at the Dow Jones, the S&P 500, and the NASDAQ. We're going to be doing a trading update, talking about what positions I am currently in right now, as well as taking a look at some stocks that are reporting earnings for the rest of this week, as well as some other just general stocks and ETFs that I'm personally just keeping my eye on for the rest of this week, some of those being ones that are reporting earnings. So before we do get into this video, guys, for everybody out there that finds value in these videos, you enjoy the breakdowns, the market updates, the trading updates, feel free to go down below and hit that like button. It really supports me and supports the channel in general, and I'm forever grateful for everybody out there that's watching these videos, subscribing to the channel, hitting that like button, and just supporting in general. It really does mean a lot to me. So let's just hop right into the topic of today's video. I don't want to waste too much time because there is quite a bit we have to talk about today. So the S&P 500, the SPX here, the 500 largest publicly traded U.S. companies ended up doing fantastic today, right? The entire market in general went absolutely bananas, right? It ended up closing at about $25.71 in the green, up nearly 0.9% here. The Dow Jones Industrial Average had not as great of a day in terms of percentage, but still a very solid green day, up $145, up 0.55% here. And the NASDAQ, guys, following a nice little tech rally that we had today, did absolutely amazing, up $101 or $103 rather, right now in the future market here, up 1.33%. And if we just hop here to the 1 day, 1 minute, we can see we ended up closing the day roughly at about 78.30, roughly about 10 points under from where we are. So it was about a 90 to 95 point day in terms of the NASDAQ at the close of the market, which is absolutely unbelievable, guys. So let's go back to the S&P 500 very quickly. You saw in the title of today's video, is the S&P 500 going to hit all-time highs? My personal opinion is a strong yes, guys. A lot of people in our community have been talking about this. We all seem to agree that we are going to hit the all-time highs, especially since we're only 7 points away as of right now. And a lot of people in our community think we're going to go to $3,000 in terms of the SPX before we see some sort of correction. And at that point, or at this point rather, you know, I can definitely see that happening. So let's just break down some technicals here, very brief, stemming off of what we ended up talking about in yesterday's video. So hopping over here to the 5 day, 5 minute. What do you guys remember that I was talking about in yesterday's video? We talked about how towards the end of the short week that we had last week on, I believe, Wednesday and Thursday, we had these two little decline days, right? Or actually, no, this was Wednesday and this was Thursday, right? We had that little decline day. The Tuesday, Wednesday were two decline days. Thursday, which was the last day of the trading week last week, we tried to pop up, but we still ended up closing under the resistance at about 29.905. And yesterday, guys, we talked about how we were seeing a slow reversal, that V pattern in the S&P, that this could be a potential breakout, right? We talked about that in yesterday's video because instead of making lower lows here like we were for most of last week, the S&P, with the way it performed yesterday, it made a higher low, right? And it ended up closing at a very slim higher high from the previous close, which was on Thursday. And this gave us, you know, on a technical basis, really the indication that we're reversing to the upside. And I talked to you guys in yesterday's video about how if we popped up in the middle of this channel, which we slowly did this morning, and we eventually tested the 29.15 level of resistance and we popped out of it, that was going to be the breakout pattern. And what happened today, guys? Exactly that. We got the breakout pattern here. The SPX pushed to a higher high in terms of the smaller charts and, of course, in terms of the larger charts. And now we're getting to those all-time highs at about 29.40. And yesterday we talked about how I believe we were like 1.2% off from all-time highs. And now you can imagine we're literally like 0.2% off. So tomorrow, if we have a slim green day, guys, we're going to make an all-time high here in the S&P 500. So just keep an eye on that for tomorrow. Let's say we pull back. The level that you want to take a look at is going to be around 29.15. This was obviously a new support level since we broke out of it as a resistance. Now we can pull back. If we pull back, who knows what's going to happen, right? But if we do pull back, that is the level that you're going to be keeping an eye on. But as of now, you know, this index is looking like it wants to hit all-time high. So the Dow Jones Industrial Average, not much to talk about here, but just like the SPX, guys, this one is very, very close to the all-time high. Not as close as the SPX, but we're about 300-ish points away from the all-time high here. And if we're just looking at percentage basis here, roughly about 0.8, 0.9% away from all-time highs right now. So that's really one very strong green day in the Dow, maybe two mini green days there. We'll be at the all-time highs. But as of now, we're simply trading in this channel from around 26,400, 26,800, that 400-point level. Not much has changed here in terms of where we're trading in the Dow from the previous couple of videos that we've done here on the channel. Just keep an eye on this. Are we going to end up breaking the 26,800 level of resistance? If we do, that's going to be the sign on a technical basis we need to see to get to those all-time highs. If we pull back, of course, the $26,400 level, that is going to be the support level that we need to see on the Dow Jones for it to maintain that level, for it to bounce back up and see, are we going to start trading horizontally in between this 400-point channel from that point in time, right? But if we pop tomorrow, you know, this might happen, right? Especially if a bunch of the earnings that are tomorrow do very well, you know, we can be pushing up very aggressively here in terms of the Dow Jones. So let's talk about the NASDAQ very quickly. Not much to say here. We're simply day in and day out here over the past couple of days. We've just been pushing to all-time highs every single day. And my phone was saying that the NASDAQ was at $8,100 today. That was definitely a glitch, because what I'm seeing here is we obviously didn't hit $8,000, right, in terms of the NASDAQ. That would have been crazy. But my phone, for some reason, very odd, on my Yahoo Finance app, actually, it was saying that we were in the 8,000 territory. So obviously, based on what I'm seeing here, that's not true, right? But we did end up hitting an all-time high today at about 78.4375. We broke out of the resistance from the previous all-time high back in October at about 77.15. So if we do see a slight pullback in the NASDAQ, since it is a bit overbought here, you know, that's going to be the level that I am looking at in terms of the NASDAQ down here, roughly at about 77.50 to about 7700-ish, that level. But as of now, not much to say on the NASDAQ, right? We're just completely blowing all-time highs here day in, day out. We're maintaining the uptrend, the 50 simple moving average here on the 184 hour chart. Everything is looking dandy in terms of the NASDAQ. So let's talk about what I ended up doing today in terms of my trading. Then we'll take a look at the earnings chart to see what you guys and what I'm personally looking at over the rest of this week in terms of what companies I'm watching. And then we'll talk about a couple of stocks that I'm watching very, very quickly. So in terms of today, guys, I ended up selling out of my Apple position today, and this is one that I was in from a couple of days ago. And if we hop to the 5-day, 5-minute, I ended up getting into Apple on this little pullback here yesterday, right, at 202.70. That's where we pulled back to. I got in at about 203.20, roughly, if I remember correctly, right around that range on this nice little pop-up. At that point, we were retesting the 50 simple moving average, right? We bounced right off of it to continue the uptrend. And today, guys, we popped all the way to 207.75. I talked about in the group chat how my goal to sell Apple was around 208. I ended up selling a bit before that just to lock in the profit, since it did move pretty aggressively from where I got in, right? I ended up getting out roughly, I believe, around 207.30 or something like that. I ended up locking roughly a 2% on Apple over this quick little two-day swing trade, and I'm really happy with that, right, guys? I talked about how I wanted to get back into Apple this week and get out before their earnings report, which is on the 30th, and that's exactly what I ended up doing, right? So very simple, very brief. That was the overall, you know, swing trading update on Apple, and I actually got into a new swing position today, which is one that I've honestly never really talked about on this channel, I feel like. I'm sure I have talked about it, but it seems like I've minimally talked about it throughout the life of this channel, and that is Procter & Gamble, ticker symbol PG. So they actually reported earnings, I think it was earlier today before the bell. They did pretty well in terms of earnings. If we go here to the live news, we can see, if we just scroll down a bit, we can see, let's see if we can see it here somewhere. Procter & Gamble, the sales were $16.46 billion versus $16.28 billion expected. If we're going up a bit here on Procter & Gamble to see the problems that they did have, it was regarding Gillette and their baby, one of their baby products. These are the reasons, in my personal opinion, why Procter & Gamble did end up falling. They beat, I'm pretty positive they beat on earnings per share. They beat on sales like you just saw. So from those two key metrics that we like to see from earnings, they did well, right? But we read and we saw how Gillette, and again, that baby product has not been doing so well, but they are innovating in the Gillette section there. And, you know, they're bringing in new products, which will help the company over time. But this is one that I got in with intentions of swing trading it. So I got in this morning at about $103.80, and we ended up selling off even more from where I got in. And I wanted to see towards the end of the day if we were going to get a green candlestick here on the 184-hour chart. We ended up getting that green candlestick on the support level here of the 180 SMA, which honestly gave me incentive to put more money into Procter & Gamble. So I'm in this one with about 75 shares right now, and this is one that I do plan on swing trading. And what I am planning, or where rather I'm planning on selling it, is about $107 right now. That is where I do have my limit order. And this is a company, guys, typically these blue chip companies, the quote unquote safer companies out there, these are ones that, you know, I like swing trading them, especially when we see a big dip, because typically, not always, guys, especially if there's bad news around it, but typically they do end up recovering. And I do think that Procter & Gamble will recover because their earnings were not catastrophic whatsoever, right? They beat on those metrics that I talked to you guys about. But again, the Gillette section is where, in my opinion, that brought down the price. And that's no big deal, right? That's probably going to blow over and the stock's going to pop back up here. So I'm in roughly at about 103.20 right now, 103.40. Roughly that's my average cost, I believe, on Procter & Gamble. And if we go from where I'm in right now up to the previous resistance around 107, that offers about 4%. And if we continue this uptrend, which could possibly happen, right? I can grasp upwards of 5%, 4.55% on this swing trade that I am planning on holding most likely for about 3-4 weeks as and if Procter & Gamble does end up recover. But let's say it doesn't go my way, which again, there's a chance, right? Because in the stock market, you can't predict everything. If we break this 180 SMA support, that is where I am most likely going to exit my position with a loss, right? So I'm just really, just keeping an eye on this one. If we continue the uptrend, I'm going to add some more money into Procter & Gamble. But as of now, that is what I'm doing with PG. And when I'm swing trading, guys, I always enter with a smaller amount of my goal position, right? So in this one, I entered with about 30%, 40% of my goal position, and I want to add more in the 105 range. That is also a goal here on Procter & Gamble. So I'm going to pull up the main chat right now. in our Discord group chat, and we're going to take a look at some of the earnings reports that are coming out tomorrow. And that's pretty much it for the trading update today, guys. Just to wrap that part of the video up, just Apple, Procter & Gamble, that's all I'm really dealing with right now. But in terms of earnings, today you can see we had Procter & Gamble, Verizon, Twitter, Snapchat. Snapchat's actually up a lot here after hours. We have eBay, TD Ameritrade. Tomorrow is actually one of the bigger days. We have Boeing, Facebook, Microsoft, AT&T, four massive companies there. We have the highly anticipated Tesla stock tomorrow, guys. Visa, PayPal, Chipotle. These are seven companies that are just absolutely massive companies, and they have, you know, a lot of weight on the overall stock market, right? So that is what I'm watching in terms of earnings for tomorrow. We can see here on Thursday we have Altria, which is a stock that I'm currently in and in my long-term portfolio. We have Southwest, Intel, the big beast, Amazon, UPS, Nokia, 3M, Comcast, a lot of these massive companies. And on Friday, American Airlines, Exxon, Chevron, Sony, guys. We have, ADM, CP, not really familiar with a bunch of these companies, but I'm sure you guys are. A bunch of just big, big, big names coming up here in terms of earnings, guys. So let's just hop over here back to the Think or Swim, and let's get into what I'm watching for the rest of this week and heading on to the month of May, guys, because May is creeping up right around the corner. So Procter & Gamble is definitely the number one stock that I'm watching. Already covered it, not going to cover it again, but that is one that I am watching here. Facebook, especially since they are reporting earnings tomorrow, this is one that's on the top of my watch list as well. We can see we're approaching that 185 resistance level. What are we going to do at this point? What are the earnings going to look like? It's going to fluctuate the stock very, very heavily, guys, in my personal opinion. If we pop out of this resistance on 185, this could be a huge signal to go long on Facebook, and if from a technical perspective, and if the earnings align with that could be a very big move there as well. Let's say we pull back and retest the 180 level, we get the earnings and it doesn't budge, but the earnings are still pretty decent. This could also be a point of entry in terms of Facebook. But at the close today, did very well, right? $2.34 in the green, up 1.29%. And let me pull up my phone very quickly because I did put notes on my phone on a couple stocks I wanted to talk about. So Procter & Gamble, we talked about that one. Roku, that's one. Roku, guys, ticker symbol R-O-K-O. This is one that's breaking out of this 50 simple moving average resistance that we do see here on the 184-hour chart. If we're hopping on this 20-day 1-hour chart, we ended up breaking the 180 SMA resistance there as well, and the 50 simple moving average resistance, which is a very good sign that we are breaking out in terms of Roku. Roku stock was actually upgraded by an analyst here, so this is definitely a positive catalyst that's moved it 10% in the past 2 days. But now, guys, what I was talking about in the group is I wanted to see a break above $60-ish. We got that break, and now I just want to see a potential pullback, a retest at around 60, and a continuation of the push to fill the channel up to 65, 66, which is the next resistance, before I do end up taking a position. But Roku is looking very, very solid as of right now. Snapchat, guys, this is one that's going ape bananas right now. I don't want to say the S word so I don't get demonetized here on YouTube, but you guys know what that word is. So Snapchat, SNAP, guys, take a look at this one. It was up about 70 cents after market hours here, and it's a positive catalyst on the earnings report because I briefly read it. They ended up doing pretty decent there. They were expecting a loss, I believe, but the loss was ended up being smaller than expected, which did pop up the stock, right? So in terms of Snapchat here, we've seen a pretty solid reversal over the past couple of months. We're maintaining that 50 SMA. So tomorrow, let's see, are we going to trend back up to the mid-12s, right? 1250 level. And if we break that resistance at 1250, we could potentially continue the uptrend. But take a look at this. What the heck? 1369? Is that where we ended up getting to? Oh my God. Wow, guys. This is the first time I'm actually seeing this. from 1198 up to 1369. Holy crap. That's like a 12% move in the blink of an eye there, and it's really cooled off a bit. So this just gives it honestly a margin of profit where we could end up refilling back up to the $13 level. We probably won't get there tomorrow because that's just a very quick reaction to the earnings. I don't know if it's going to pop up that much, but who knows, guys. I'm going to be keeping an eye on it for, again, the push to the 1250s, upper 12s, maybe 1270. You know, this could happen tomorrow with the volatility from the earnings report. This could be a good day trade, to be completely frank with you all, and I am going to be watching it tomorrow. Ticker symbol SNAP, the infamous Tesla, guys. That's the next one I want to talk about here. They are reporting earnings as well, and in terms of a technical basis here, Tesla ended up holding the 255-ish level of support here in today's trading session. I do believe it sold off all the way to that level. Yup, it sold off all the way to 255, bounced right off of that, ended up breaking their resistance at 262. We bounced on it as a new support, ended up closing the day at around $264 per share. So Tesla is one of those that I'm pretty positive, guys. Again, no one really knows, but I'm pretty sure Tesla's going to move a lot to the upside or a lot to the downside tomorrow after their earnings report. So this is one that, let's say they blow earnings out of the park, which a lot of people aren't expecting that. A lot of people are expecting Tesla's earnings to be bad, but let's say they blow it out of the park and we end up breaking out of these SMA resistance levels that have been resistance levels, the 50 and the 180 here over the past couple of months. You know, this could be a very bullish move on Tesla on a technical basis, and that would be a sign in my eyes to hop into it as a swing trade, especially if the guidance is positive and especially if, you know, the earnings report's positive, right? But again, a lot of people aren't expecting that, and it can really move either way. But Tesla is on my watch list, guys. It should be a fun day tomorrow. Let's see some other ones. I'm forgetting now off the top of my head. So just keep an eye. You know, Microsoft is at all-time highs right now, right? We see Tesla. You know, that's going to be crazy. Like we said, Visa and PayPal, keep an eye on those two. Those are larger cap stocks that could move up or down, right? Let's take a look at them really quickly, right? Visa is ticker symbol V. You know, this one's already at an all-time high, so I'm most likely not going to be playing that unless we do dip on earnings, maybe for a potential dip buy on Visa. PayPal, let's take a look at this one. This one's kind of decent, right? Let's say we pull back a bit more on earnings and we slowly start to scoop back up on a positive earnings report. Let's say the guidance is decent, but we get a pullback, something like a Procter & Gamble move here. You know, PayPal could be a good entry for a swing, but we have to see what those earnings are like. They're tomorrow after market hours on the 24th of April. So I'm going to end off the video here, guys. Just a couple of stocks. I hope you guys really watch these. They're going to be volatile tomorrow. PayPal, Visa, Tesla, you know, Facebook, Microsoft, you know, Chipotle, all these different stocks. They're going to be fun to watch tomorrow. I sure am watching them, as well as Apple, you know, Procter & Gamble. These are just a couple that I'm watching tomorrow. So if you enjoyed this video, feel free to go down below and hit that like button, guys. It really, again, supports me and supports the channel, and I really do appreciate if you guys do that. And if you're new to the channel, feel free to subscribe if you want to see daily content like this, market updates, trading updates, stock news, earnings reports. That would be great if you were to subscribe and keep up with the content and keep up with the community. And I actually made a video yesterday talking about a warning and really why you should be cautious on trading during earnings. So go check out that video. It's going to be up here, you know, in the recommended or whatever it's called. You guys will see it. Go check out that video if you are interested. And again, I really do appreciate all of you guys watching. I'll catch you all in the next video. Peace out.